Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. As per usual, today's video will be kicking off with some standard SpaceX information. There was a tweet at Elon Musk in which he was asked, so we can safely conclude that none of your other companies will be going public anytime soon. Musk responded and said it will most likely make sense for Starlink to go public once the revenue growth is reasonably predictable. There was an interesting tweet from Stephen Mull with a picture of the Falcon 9 boosters of 2020. He captioned it saying, SpaceX carried out a record-breaking 26 launches this year, but how many boosters did it take to get it done? The answer is 11, and here they are. Musk responded to that and said Falcon was 25% of successful orbital launches in 2020, but maybe a majority of payload to orbit. Anyone done the math? Somebody responded with, according to my calculations and the data of all the known masses since some are unknown, more than 416,467 kilograms were launched, of which 238,617 were launched by SpaceX. That is more than 57.2% of the total mass sent. We also have something new in relation to SpaceX's facility in Boca Chica and their operations. The FAA is doing an environmental review and have posted an article saying they're holding a public scoping period. It says the scoping period will help the FAA to determine the scope of issues for analysis in the draft environmental assessment. In addition to this, it says the FAA requests public comments on potential alternatives and impacts and identification of any relevant information, studies or analyses of any kind concerning impacts affecting the quality of the human environment. In the production area, it looks like a super heavy barrel section has had an issue. It was also seen being moved to be disposed of. Going forward, videos will be quite a bit shorter and include less Boca Chica activity. However, for this video, we have some cool footage to look at with regards to SN8's 12.5km flight. SpaceX posted this awesome recap video. You will likely know from my last video that SN9 was rolled out and placed on top of the suborbital launch mount at Pad B. In response to the SN8 recap video, Musk posted a tweet saying 12-story rocket turns off its engines and does a controlled fall. In response to that tweet, somebody asked any major changes needed to keep up the header tank pressure in SN9. Musk responded to that and said only minor changes would be needed. Marcus House retweeted a picture of SN9 on the pad from RGV aerial photography. He also tweeted it saying, interesting they are using Pad B this time around. I wonder what the possibility will be of seeing SN10 sitting there on pad A alongside. Elon Musk responded with some very exciting info saying that it's coming soon. As they prepare this vehicle for its turn to make history, engineers were seen working underneath to install another Raptor engine. This Raptor you can see is serial number 49. On the Cameron County website, looking at the dates, they are still the same with a primary road and beach closure of tomorrow, Monday 18th. Then there's also backup dates of Tuesday and Wednesday should SpaceX need some more time. However, as soon as Monday, we could see SN9 begin its testing campaign. I can't wait. Last episode, I mentioned that SN10 had been moved, and here you can see it heading into the high bay in place of SN9. The nose cone for SN10 has also been seen getting its other canard. With the nose almost complete and the tank section in the high bay, we could see them stacked together soon. We also have some news related to the first super heavy booster currently under construction. Musk was asked when we can expect to see it do its first hop test, with Musk saying just a few months. It's going to be insane to see that booster perform a hop test. To finish up the video, we have the latest diagram thanks to Brendan Lewis showing an overview of the prototypes under construction and already built. As always, thanks to Mary, known more commonly as Boca Chica Gal, for going out there and capturing the incredible footage. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes to bring us the latest space coverage. I also want to include a little promo for our Discord server if you want to join a bunch of space nerds, there's a link in the description. We also have a store with some cool SpaceX themed stickers, so check them out if you're interested, there's a link to that too in the description. That's it for this episode of The SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.